know, we're gonna base it on. Are you working?
Yes, sir.
This is? Yeah.
Currently, I'm probationed in the Indian Postal Service.
Oh, good.
Now, recently, Pakistan has taken some action against one of the terrorists. What action have they taken?
Sir, the terrorist that we're talking about is chief of Lashkar-e-Taiba, Jamaat-e-Tawhid. And he was arrested for involving in terror financing. And Pakistan arrested him based on his previous records from the pressure of FATF.
Now, he has been, what sentence has he been given by the court?
Sorry, sir, not a sentence.
Has he been convicted by the court in Pakistan for his actions in India?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of the
okay. Now, another man whose name has been coming up is Masood Azhar. Yes. Who is he?
Sir, he was the one who was involved in our the Mumbai blast that took place in 2008.
That was Hafiz. That was the Lashkar-e-Taiba. Masood Azhar was Jaish-e-Mohammed. What has Pakistan said about him?
Sorry, sir.
Okay. Now, you mentioned that due to pressure of the FATF, the courts have taken action against the LET chief. So, what is this FATF?
Sir, FATF is Financial Action Task Force, which was established in 1989 by G7 countries. And the main purpose of FATF is to control money laundering and terror financing. And it acts through a multilateral body, and it places countries on grey list and black list based upon their activities that they are taking upon curbing terrorism.
So initially, when it was formed, was terror financing a part of the charter or no?
So initially, it was money laundering.
Subsequently, terror financing was also brought in.
Yes.
Now, what were the grounds on which Pakistan was put on the grey list?
Sir, India has put its viewpoint in FATF that Pakistan is involved in proxy wars in India, and it has been giving safe havens to terrorists in its own territory and training them and sending to India. So this has been one of the grounds on which it was put on grey list.
So it was put on grey list last year.
Yes.
Now, currently the FATF meeting is going on. I think today is the last day perhaps. So has any decision been taken yet on Pakistan?
Yes, sir. The review committee has given that Pakistan should stay in grey list.
Correct. For up to June, they have been given time.
Yes, sir.
There are certain points which were given against which Pakistan had to take action. So some of them have been covered by Pakistan, but not all of them.
No.
The government has been trying to give a fillip to sports, and they had started something called the Khelo Games.
Yes.
You aware of that?
Yes.
Now, another series is now to be held called the Khelo India Youth Games. What is this?
I'm not exactly aware of Khelo India Youth Games.
Right. What was the early ones were?
So the Khelo India program that...
That's right. Yeah. Last year they had Khelo India school games.
School.
And now they have moved up, you know, about 17 and above. So they are now having Khelo India Youth Games. They are going to be held in...
I'll look into it.
Yeah, in Bhubaneswar. Okay. Now, you know, have you heard of the Bodo Accord?
Yes.
What is the Bodo Accord?
So it was recently signed by among the parties of Indian government, the Assam government, and the Bodo groups.
So what would you say is the most important achievement of this accord?
So it stopped the militancy in those areas and has given a window to preserve the culture.
Yeah, it is the militant groups, insurgent groups, have given up the demand for statehood. That is what is the main issue. Insurgency revives again, that's for us to see.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Tell me, Teja.
Yes,
what do you think are the main issues in which our country should focus?
Sir, there are few issues which we should continue.
Mm-hmm.
First is, sir, ensuring sustainability in agriculture.
Mm-hmm.
And because a lot of our workforce is dependent on agriculture,
mm-hmm.
so we need to make it profitable and shift most of them into manufacturing and service.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yes. So secondly, though we are currently fifth largest economy in the world, but there's a lot of income inequality and economic inequality in our country. So
yes, yes, our per capita is $2,000.
Yes,
which is nothing.
Yes, so we need to address the income inequality. Sir, third is that we need to concentrate
income inequality or no income scenario for about 20 crore people, poverty.
Poverty, yes, sir. So, I mean, it's an economic angle of reducing inequality as well as addressing poverty.
Mm-hmm.
So third is the our investment in manufacturing sector,
mm-hmm.
and also in developing startups in our country.
Mm-hmm.
So that because that will create wealth in the country and which will further promote overall development.
Okay.
Fourth is, sir, we should concentrate on our national interest.
Incidentally, the startup program, has it done any good at all till date? About 4 years, I think, has gone.
Yes.
Yeah. What has happened? You heard of good startups doing well? 4 years is enough time,
yes,
for a startup.
So we have some unicorns in our Indian startups,
mm-hmm.
like Dream 11, Flipkart, OYO.
That has nothing to do with this program, right?
Yes.
I am asking about this program.
So this particular program, I'm not aware of the evaluation part of it.
Nothing much has happened, apparently. Okay, now, what do you think? This Ayodhya temple is a government affair or a private affair?
Sir, it's a private affair, and government has tried to intervene in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
But however, we got a Supreme Court mediated solution later.
Mm-hmm. So, but now government has nothing to do with it?
Sir, in the Supreme Court judgment, the Supreme Court asked the government to establish a trust to build the temple. And also allocate 5 acres to the Muslim group so that they can build their mosque in the.
No, that solution is over, accepted by both sides.
Yes.
What I am saying is the government still involved? Does it need to get itself involved now?
Sir, in order to maintain the communal harmony, the government should try to work on those lines.
Supreme Court has maintained communal harmony. I don't think they are fighting now at the ground level.
Yes, sir.
Right? Because I am asking you these questions because I saw a newspaper article with a photograph that the Prime Minister is meeting these people today. Right? Does the Prime Minister have time for all this? You know, because you said poverty and this and that, startup, nothing has happened. So, why does he need to meet them?
Sir, it sends out a very good message, and as a symbol, it acts that Prime Minister of India is for all communities, and he has in his mind interest of all communities of the country.
That he has said many times.
Yes.
Do you really need to meet people?
Sir, but it is.
You think it is necessary? If you
yes,
were
sir.
Prime Minister, you would have met.
Yes, sir.
Is that so?
Yes, sir. Because it will send a very good message.
What message? There is no message. तब तो शंकराचार्य से भी मिलो, इससे भी मिलो, उससे भी मिलो, कितने मिलते रहेंगे
सर? Because
SGPC से मीटिंग करो, है ना? आर्कबिशप से मिलो, पोप को रिसीव करो, प्राइम मिनिस्टर के काम है।
Sir,
you think Prime Minister is meant for this?
Sir, it is one of his duties to maintain peace and law and order in the country.
Sir, state subject, bhaiya, law and order. Law and order is not a central subject.
Yes.
UP Chief Minister is there for that. Although UP Chief Minister also has no role in this, but if there is law and order, he should handle it. Okay, very much. That's all.
You are interested in watching TED Talks.
Mm-hmm.
What are TED Talks?
TED Talks are a platform where people from diverse backgrounds give talks on their work, and it is maximum 18 minutes that they get, and they present their ideas in a very innovative way.
Mm-hmm.
And the fields range from technology, entertainment, design, science, religion.
Have you given any TED talk?
No, not yet. I would love to give one.
Pardon?
I would love to give one.
What does TED stand for?
Yes, sir. It is technology, entertainment, and design.
Okay. Now there's you're from Telangana,
yes.
And there's a scheme known as Hriday. Are
yes,
you aware?
Yes, Hriday.
What was the scheme?
Hriday scheme is for
Heritage City Development and
I'm not
Augmentation
aware.
Yojana.
Thank you.
So what is being done in this scheme?
Ma'am, I'm not exactly aware of what Telangana government is doing in this.
Mm-hmm.
But we have certain heritage cities like Bhadrachalam Temple.
Mm-hmm.
And
what about Varangal?
Yes, ma'am.
That's in Telangana?
Yes,
Hyderabad?
We have Varanasi, which is very close to Hyderabad district. We have Thousand Pillar Temple.
Yes, Thousand Pillar Temple. So it is for their looking after these places. Because we already have the smart city project.
Yes.
So to look after the heritage cities, this was initiated. You are from Hyderabad. Tell me something about Hyderabad.
Ma'am, Hyderabad is a cosmopolitan city.
Places of interest?
In Hyderabad, we can see Charminar. We have Tank Bund, that is a necklace road, which is a famous recreational place. And we have Chilkur Balaji Temple, who is known as Visa Baba, because people come there for their visa. And we have various technological parks, where we have companies like Google and Amazon setting up their headquarters here. And apart from that, ma'am, we have a lot of very good food culture in Hyderabad. So we have a lot of food chains to visit.
Good. Now, there are some very interesting schemes of the Telangana government. Can you mention any of them?
Yes, ma'am.
Which are doing good work?
Yes, ma'am. Few are the Raitu Bandhu scheme.
What is this Raitu Bandhu?
Ma'am, it is an investment guarantee scheme to the public, to the farmers.
To the farmers, yes.
They are given 5,000 rupees per season. And they have the full autonomy to use this money in the best interest of their field. And it is seen as a very good move, because it gives the farmer the autonomy to decide about his field.
But the Kalia scheme, which is in Odisha, it also includes the landless laborers.
Yes.
But Raitu Bandhu doesn't.
Doesn't, yes ma'am.
Okay.
So that scheme also includes the agricultural laborers, and also it provides livelihood opportunities.
Yes, yes.
Whereas Telangana scheme is only for the farmers with land records.
Okay, so what are the other schemes?
Ma'am, the other one is the Kaleshwaram project, which is a multi-purpose project.
But there's a lot of controversy about the Kaleshwaram project.
Yes, ma'am.
How many trees will be cut down? How many trees which are in the extinct species will be cut down?
Yes, ma'am. So, there were environmental concerns as well as some lacunes in implementation.
Yeah.
And the project hasn't reached its timeline yet, deadline yet. So, and also there were cost overruns in the scheme. So, these are some concerns with the scheme.
And some water schemes like the Kakatiya and
yes,
the Bhagiratha.
Yes,
tell me about them.
Mission Kakatiya is for regenerating the lakes that were built by Kakatiya rulers. It is about desilting and regenerating them, the surface water. Whereas Mission Bhagiratha is about providing water supply, drink tap
water. So, is water supply given to all the households now?
Ma'am, currently the tap connections are given, but the water is being released in phased manner, which is not 100% yet, but it is in a stages
only. You've done mechanical engineering.
Yes.
What is the difference between robots and drones?
Ma'am, robots are any instrument that performs activities in a mechanical way, in a automated way.
Okay.
And drones can be said to be one form of robot which generally fly in the air, and they use for surveillance and capturing images for such purposes.
Okay. Now, my last question, since you are in the postal services, should our postal services be privatized?
Ma'am, before privatization, we need to first corporatize the postal system. And we have recommendations from TSR Subramanian Committee. That.
What are these recommendations?
Yes, ma'am, because the recommendations are based on the activities of postal department, because it is involved in banking, insurance, e-commerce and mail operation. So the committee recommended that each of these units should be first set up as business units. They have to corporatize these units, and then we can also offer IPOs in the future. So first step has been taken in the direction by establishing the India Post Payment Banks.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
You have studied mathematics.
Yes.
Give me an example of a set of all sets. Give me an example of a set of all sets that are not members of themselves. Now you are from Telangana. Can you tell me something about the Disha Act?
Yes, sir. So, Disha Act has been passed by the AP Legislative Assembly because after the incident that has happened in the Hyderabad about a rape victim got assaulted. So, the Disha Act is mostly caters to speedy trials of the rape cases within 21 days by establishing separate courts and by employing separate staff in order to look after such cases.
Over the years, there have been many acts that have been brought in at the central level or at the state level to curb crimes against women. Have they been effective? And do you think the Disha Act will be effective?
Sir, we have taken some legislations like the POXO Act as well as sexual harassment against women at work, prevention of sexual harassment at workplaces. Sir, however, we can see that the crimes against women, according to the data we see, they are increasing. And we have also set up Nirbhaya Fund in order to get one-stop centers. But those implementation has also not happened the satisfactory limit yet.
What is the corpus of the Nirbhaya Fund?
Sorry, sir.
10,000 crores. How much has been used? 9%. What are the areas for which assistance can be given under the Nirbhaya Fund?
Sir, for all three, main three purposes are the legal assistance, the medical assistance, and the judicial, the process that takes place.
The most important, safety and security,
safety, yes,
particularly in transport. The same UN is going to be 75 years old. One of the objectives which is contained in the UN Charter is equality of human beings. Now, to what extent do you think it has been achieved?
Sir, we can say it has been a mixed response, in the sense that all countries have achieved equal status in terms of voting, that is political equality, you can see at the international level. However, if you see the income inequality, that is the economic inequality or the social inequality that exists between the countries and between intra-country inequality has been addressed yet. So, we can say we have reached a good status but not the desired status.
So, access to healthcare and food, etc. Now, which is the principal organ of UN which is engaged in the area of equality of human beings, to bring about equality of human beings?
Sir, UN Human Rights Commission.
That is for human rights. Economic and Social Council. Okay.
Which major foreign companies have set shop in Hyderabad?
Sir, there are a few companies like Google, Amazon, IKEA, and Uber. So these are some MNCs.
Is Walmart also there?
I'm not aware of.
Now, what do you think of this IKEA and Amazon and Walmart? These are also, they have their, one or two of them have their physical stores, but mostly they are selling online.
Yes.
What do you think of them coming to India? Is it a healthy thing? A correct thing for Indian economy and Indian consumer?
Yes, sir. If you see from the consumer's perspective, then definitely it brings a lot of competition into the market and innovation in the marketplace, and also for affordability of the consumer increases. However, there are some concerns like dealing with the small hawkers or the traditional retail shoppers, which have expressed their concerns regarding these shops. So we can look at it as a, if you look at it from the economic angle, then definitely we can call it as a creative destruction, because whenever a new idea comes into the market, then the old ideas are replaced by them. So we need to take concerns of these hawkers and retailers in our mind and take measures accordingly.
What concern we can take? Either you allow them to prosper and satisfy your customer, bring a lot of FDI, or you should ask them to shut shop and let the hawkers thrive. You can't have both. Someone will have to go.
Sir, for
a country, what is healthier?
Sir, in the near future, we have to, at least in the short term, we have to take the concerns, sir. Like Amazon as a marketplace, it provides platform for all retailers in that sense. So they can be integrated into the system instead of either or. We can have a middle path where we can integrate them into the e-commerce system. And as far as hawkers are concerned, so we can provide them alternate markets, so we can provide them some skilling so that they can also be upgraded in their...
It is not hawker who is crying. It is this RSS-backed people, brick-and-mortar store fellows.
Yes, sir.
Hawker is not affected by Amazon. No. He is selling something else.
We have such examples in the past also.
If you want to prosper, then the line is very clear. You allow them to continue. Let those brick-and-mortar, they should also become efficient as these are.
Yes, sir.
It will improve the competition.
So that will happen through promoting competition, but not by restricting any one of them, sir.
So who is restricting?
Sir, like the yes, the concerns are that they have from the retailers are that they have to constrain the big giants. But
CCI started an investigation. What happened to that?
Sorry, sir.
No. High Court has put a stop to it. They said, no, you give us a reason why you are starting this investigation. High Court is not convinced.
Looking at
it. Is Postal Department an ailing department?
Sir, in terms of revenue, if you see, then that we have incurred losses over time. But as such, Postal Department's mandate is, along with business development, it is also the universal service obligation. That is to serve the underserved and unserved areas of the country with mail operations and banking facilities. So if you judge it in that terms, then definitely Postal Department is doing good.
Is there water scarcity in Hyderabad?
Yes, sir. In some areas, there is water scarcity.
And water is supplied by tankers or what?
Yes, sir. Some areas are supplied by tankers.
So is the government doing something about it?
Yes, sir.
What is specific steps have been initiated?
So one is about regenerating the lakes in Hyderabad city.
Which ones have been done, rejuvenated?
So the works are still on, but the main one is the Gandipet Lake and the Necklace Road that the Musi River flows through those areas. So those are the main lakes that have been regenerated in the city as of now.
They have been rejuvenated.
I'm sorry, so they're still in the phases of not yet fully complete.
Still thinking is going on.
Yes. The works have begun, but the process...
Is there a Nobel Prize for maths?
No, sir, no Nobel Prize. But we have a Fields Medal and Abel's Prize.
Which of them is considered the bigger one?
So Fields Medal is Fields the most famous.
Which country awards it and who got the last time?
Sir, it is awarded by Canada.
Mm.
And last year it was given to Akash Venkatesan. He's from Australia.
Okay. Is game theory a field of mathematics?
It can be seen as a mathematics application in economics.
How will you define it? Game theory?
So game theory deals with the strategies that need to be employed when different parties are fighting or different parties are demanding one particular resource. Like we can use it in
balls. How does it do it? What does game theory do? What is the purpose of this game theory?
Sir, it gives the best strategy to go about in fields like war.
By doing what? By studying what?
By studying the other person, the opponents.
Studying the patterns.
Patterns, yes.
Patterns, and then outlines a strategy for the future.
Yes.
Supreme Court's powers are defined in Article 141 and 142. What are these powers?
sorry, sir, I'm unable to recall it.
So we close the interview. I'll give you feedback. How do you think you have handled the interview?
It could have been better, sir. There are some gaps.
No, I think you have done very well. You have been able to handle most questions nicely. Now, we feel that most of the questioning will be based on environment. Telangana, you are in postal service, some questions on postal service. Then mathematics, mechanical engineering, and finally, current affairs. Like you were asked about Kelo India, Bodo, Raitu Bindu, etc. Some questions on foreign policy.
Yes.
These are the areas where you should prepare yourself. That Telangana has some problems and some good things are there, like it has been able to progress economically.
Yes.
Human development index is also improving. But then there are also some problems like Muslim reservation for Muslims.
Yes.
It was shut down by the judiciary.
And not the farmer suicides.
So they agree.
Yes.
These are some of the problems. Then current affairs and constitutional issues, like what is good governance concept, what is basic structure concept, you know, these are the things. You were asked a question about incomes, income rising, income inequality. You are confusing it, raising the income. Are you trying to say that you should rob the rich and fill the pocket of the poor? That is the impression you are giving by linking it to raising. Instead, productivity must increase.
Okay.
Don't harp so much on it. Income disparity.
Yes.
When you were corrected also, then you again came back to the income inequality.
Okay.
As if you will take away from the rich and give it to the poor.
Okay,
so
that was not the intention.
Point is, you improve that.
Yes.
Then you were asked a question about Prime Minister, you know, holding these meetings on the temple and all. You should be, as a student, should be absolutely clear in mind. Secularism doesn't permit this. India's secularism. This is all wrong. You should, if anyone asks you, I know most probably nobody will ask you an interview, but if anyone asks you, you say leaders have no business doing these kind of things. We should remain above these religious activities and religious symbols.
So like if at all they ask that Indian form of secularism is different from that of Western secularism.
What is the Indian form of secularism?
Like protection of all religions equally.
So you are protecting only one. Why doesn't he wear a Muslim garb, Mr. Modi? Why doesn't he set up a foundation stone for a mosque?
But like that will be controversial.
He's doing it only for Hindus.
Yes.
So isn't this a discrimination?
I mean, can you say that in the interview?
No. You don't have to say, I'm meeting your point.
Okay.
That,
so, like, my point also
that
was like...
He's ostensibly giving an impression that he's a Hindu leader, which is wrong.
Okay. So in the interview, if they ask such questions...
Yes,
so
you say, no, it is wrong. I consider this totally wrong. A leader must not keep himself away from religious symbols or religious activities and show a neutral stance completely. Okay?
Yes.
All right.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.